Hey guys, welcome to this Laravel technique video. In this one, we're going to take a look at how to build this cookie pop-up over here in the left-hand corner. If you're not familiar with cookies, they're basically used to manage user sessions, personal preferences, and to track any kind of user behavior. Now, there's many ways to implement a cookie pop-up or cookies. So I'm going to take a really straightforward approach with this one using Laravel 9 and some packages. So we'll get you started. And we'll also have some functionality where we can try to like click away and close this thing if you stick around for the end of the tutorial. Okay, thanks for jumping in. Let's get started. Before we get into styling this dialog box, there's a few things I'd like to mention. So what's the second way of implementing this? Well, we can go to our app directory up here. We can go to HTTP and we can go to our kernel.php file. And we can add the middleware to this array. And the one we're gonna do is the spotty, and we're gonna take the cookie consent middleware. Okay, so the first one, and then we're gonna add the class. So adding this to the kernel is effectively the same as adding the include blade directive. Let's have a look. And we refresh, and as we can see, it's back. The other thing we have to note is, let's check out this sessions.php file. So we have to keep in mind that the cookie domain is set by the domain key. So this is located right here under config session.php. So you should make sure that you add this value to your .env file. If you're using a domain port with, you know, something like localhost, 3000, 8000 or something like that, this package won't work until you do so. So let's get to changing the actual text, the contents that's, you know, available in the message and the agree. So we did the sure in the agree part, and you could just, you know, grab this here and you could delete it and you could place something else inside there entirely. So this really depends on the legislation that is available for your area and what message you need to place and what is necessary. For the sake of this tutorial, we're not going to really take the legislation seriously here. So I'm just going to paste in this content. And as you can see, whatever we change here gets translated over here. Okay. So yeah, Kevin is totally cool with cookies. I totally am, by the way. What's also nice about this approach is if you had to do something around localization, you could implement other languages with the same message. So you just click on the language that you're looking for. Let's say French. If you had implemented localization, you could then come into this directory and change the message accordingly to something that was appropriate. Now this is good. I want to actually show you this, and this probably happens because of the escape characters and just using French. So something like this, where, you know, I have the double quotes here, I'd have to escape those just to make sure that it works correctly. And in French, sometimes you have like these special characters, these symbols that sometimes may play havoc with the actual output. But be sure to keep that in mind when you're doing languages, depending on where you live and what you're doing.
I gotta go. Okay. You know what? I'm gonna get back to work and you guys get back to the video. Okay. They're still there. All right. I'm going.
Okay guys, it's time for an Easter egg. So as of this video, I believe Tailwind is sitting at version 3.1. So that's a new update. And I'm gonna show you how to update your Tailwind within a Laravel project if you have installed Jetstream and you wanted to just bump it up. So in our terminal, we're just gonna type in npm install -d and we're gonna say Tailwind CSS. I'm gonna run that, give the package.json a refresh. And as you can see, we're at 3.1.2. Now we're gonna add a couple more plugins in here. So if we go to the Tailwind config file, so the other two we're going to add is Tailwind aspect ratio and Tailwind line clamp. So we're just gonna go npm and we're gonna install. I think you can always use this flag too if it's too long to type install. Just go npm I, and we're gonna do the aspect ratio. And we're also gonna do one more, line clamp. So if we go back to our package.json file, we'll see that these have been added to the dev dependency. And now it's just a matter of actually adding this to our config file. And we'll add these two. Next thing that's kind of new here in Tailwind 3.1 is we're gonna add this type import tailwindcss.config just above our exports here. That should do it. and I'll provide a link to all the details that Adam had provided with the updates for this import. All right, let's give it a run. NPM run dev, see if everything's still working correctly. And looks like we're good. You may have noticed this right here, this cookie.svg. I went to my Webpack file. Nothing really special here. All I did was create an SVG folder in the resources directory, and then when I run mix, it gets published to the public SVG directory. And I added the actual cookie SVG icon that we'll be using in our final design. So last thing to take care of, we're going to install Alpine.js. So we're going to use npm install and the library's Alpine.js. We're going to run that. And we go back to our package.json file, you'll see that Alpine.js latest version just got plugged in right here. And that'll come into when we add some functionality with the modal disappearing and toggling on and off. And we'll take a look at that. And that's it for this one, guys. Don't forget to like the video if you found this useful. Leave your comments and thoughts below. Take care, and I will see you next time.